Not had any discussions. I read about it in the paper this morning or yesterday morning. But the at the end of the day, Foxconn is going to make decisions based on tariffs and all sorts of other issues that impact them. So our goal as a state has always been and always will be making sure that they're accountable, making sure that the taxpayers are feel comfortable about this. Certainly, we want them to bring as many jobs as possible. If that happens, that's great. But transparency is important, so we're gonna keep on keeping on, making sure that we hold them accountable for the issues that they've agreed to. But at the end of the day, they're gonna be making business decisions, and hopefully those business decisions happen in a way that have more jobs in the state.
Joint Finance is well into its process at mm-hmm. this point. You've seen this all play out. You said everything is on the table, including the possibility of vetoing mm-hmm. the entire budget. What's the likelihood that you would veto the entire budget?
Oh, it's too early to tell. I know you're absolutely right. They're kind of screeching to a conclusion here. But until I see that final budget, and I'll give a small example, the surplus that we have in the state, I think it's been spent two or three times. And so, you know, I need to see where that money's coming from and whether it's a sustainable source, all those things. So it's gonna be, you know, all hands on deck in our office to make sure that we understand exactly what's put in this budget going forward. Joint Finance Committee is one step. The next step is have both bodies pass the budget. But at the end of the day, I have options to veto the entire budget or just parts of it or none of it, unlikely. But we'll see. It's still too early. But we are prepared for any possibility. We're not waiting till the end to figure this out. We're making sure that we understand every piece of the way that what has been passed, and so that we know what the options are when the whole package is done.